हेलो फ्रेंड्स, नमस्कार। टैक्सेशन ऑफ कैशबैक पॉइंट्स इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन विच नीड्स एन आंसर फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ पब्लिक बेनिफिट, दैट द पब्लिक एट लार्ज नाउ डेज हु इज मोर और लेस लिविंग इन अ डिजिटल इकोनॉमी इज कंटिन्यूअसली डीलिंग इन टू डिजिटाइज ट्रांजेक्शन एंड इन डिजिटाइज ट्रांजेक्शन पर्टिकुलरली वेन वी आर डीलिंग इन टू क्रेडिट कार्ड रिजीम The cashback points are received as a credit in your credit card statement. Whether such cashback points or any reward points or any instant discount would be taxable in the hands of an assessee or not, this was a question in my mind with that perspective, I am today there before you to bring clarity, rather tax clarity on such particular issue. So what are the various incentives which could be there maybe in one form or another form, which may be looked into from the point of view of taxation perspective, say one cashback which you receive while using your credit card, debit card, the reward points which you become entitled to because of the usage of a credit card, the instant discount or rebate which is allowed to you on usage of a particular net banking, debit card, credit card, etc. So we will try to see or we will try to cover all these particular aspects in today's video. Before I move further, one more question which came in my mind was that whether the connection to the source of income is relevant in such particular reward points if I assume that they are taxable. That say, for example, you are a salaried paid person, you are a businessman, or you have any other source of income. What is the impact? Prima facie, if you are a businessman and you are doing such transactions during the course of such business which are creating certain reward points to you, then it may be preferred to be treated as business income. But otherwise, in all other cases, maybe you are a salaried paid person or not a businessman and you are receiving any credit, and if I assume that such a credit is your income, such a reward point, such a cashback is your income, then it will basically fall into other source income only. So this is one aspect to see if these particular transactions are taxable. Now, my dear friends, I come on the main topic, that what is the taxation of cashback or reward points in your hands. In my understanding, I have put here two points for your consideration, that have you received credit in your bank credit card statement for such points, or have you adjusted such points against any future purchases or payments or not. Say for example, you have used your credit card to the extent of rupees 2 lakh, and because of 2 lakh rupees use, you have become entitled to get a benefit of 2000 credit card points. Now let's assume each of such credit card point worth rupees 1. So you are therefore entitled for rupees 2000 credit. Now this 2000 rupees which is appearing in your credit card as credit card point, prima facie should not be taxed unless you convert them into rupee, maybe for adjusting your credit card bill, or maybe for using those particular credit card points for adjustment against any other purchase which you make from such particular credit cards use. So the point which I would like to take home from here is that any particular reward point or cashback point which is credited to your account, prima facie should not be taxed unless you utilize them. Moment you utilize them for any particular bills adjustment or for any particular purchases adjustment, in those scenarios, such particular credit could be treated to be income. So this is what is a very important aspect which I wanted to highlight through this video. Similarly, friends, like when there is a credit card usage and you become entitled to reward point, there are many a cases when you go for some online purchase and you find that the relevant site is saying that, okay, you use this particular bank's credit card or debit card and we'll give you an instant discount of say 2%, 5%, 10% or so. So when you avail an instant discount because of a use of a particular credit card or debit card, whether such particular instant discount or rebate can also be treated to be income? My opinion on such particular matter differs from my previous opinion of reward points or credit card points. I am of the mind that if I am going to purchase an amount, a particular item to the extent of say rupees 1 lakh, and by use of a particular credit card, I am now supposed to pay only net net 95,000 rupees. In my opinion, the 5,000 short payment should not be treated to be my income, because the effective payout from my pocket is only rupees 95,000 because of a use of a particular credit card or debit card. So there I don't see prima facie any possibility of income arising in the hands of the user of such debit card, credit card, etc. One more question, my dear friends, could be that whether such amount, if such amount is so received, can be there in terms of enjoying any exemption limit in relation to such credit card related points. Say for example, for the year a person might have received 2 lakh rupees reward points or cashback points because of he being using his credit card in volumes. So these 2 lakh points, say they are equivalent to 2 lakh rupees only, and he has utilized those particular 2 lakh rupees also for some purchases, etc., then whether he is entitled to avail any basic exemption limit, I would not say a no. Basic exemption limit could be enjoyed. But you can understand a person who is using his credit card so voluminously, so naturally his total income would certainly be in some higher slab rate. So the question of basic exemption limit generally does not arise. But where you are treating such particular credit card points or reward points as income, then I would remind you to take care of the taxation of section 56 subsection 2 clause 10, which says that if I treat these particular reward points as gift from the relevant banking company to you, then up to rupees 50,000 rupees for a year from all sources, whatever gift you receive, say in money, there would not be any taxation. So say if your total reward points for a year in INR term are 38,000 rupees, then I would say don't worry, unless you have no other gifts during the year in form of money from other person. But say if your total reward points which you have utilized during the year are touching rupees 1 lakh, then that 1 lakh rupees equivalent amount which you have utilized either adjustment of the credit bill or for the payment of any other bills of yours, then that 1 lakh rupees which has exceeded rupees 50,000, the full amount would be taxable in my opinion. I hope, my dear friends, that this particular topic which I selected certainly would have been able to give you clarity regarding the taxation. My general understanding is that we are basically not too much concerned about the taxation of such reward points, but if there is a user who is using such particular or who is indulged into such particular transaction in volumes, for those kind of people, this particular video would certainly be of great use. So, thanking you very much for listening to me. Wishing you all the best. Jai Hind.